the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We welcome you to this celebration of the Eucharist. Welcome to all who may be visiting. Peter says, Lord, it is good that we are here. Yes, indeed, it's good that we are here. We're going to speak about how, in an ideal world, every Mass would be a mountaintop experience. And what does that mean? As we become transfigured with the Lord. So as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth we praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers, and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship, grant, we pray, to your servants, that listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was snow bright, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne. The Lord is King. The Lord is King. The Most High over all the earth. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord, before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, all people see his glory. High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods. The Lord is King, the Lord is King, the Most High over
a reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we had been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Alleluia.
You.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves, and he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, it is good that we are here. They say there's two people, people that like the mountains and people that like the ocean. The nice thing about being here in New England is we get a little of both. I grew up in New London and spent hours and hours and hours on Guthrie Beach, mostly sitting under the umbrella. And now I visit my skin doctor. But I have to admit, my real happy place is in the mountains. And that's where God really speaks to my heart. My earliest memories are from going up to Waterville Valley to go skiing with my family in New Hampshire. And I feel like I know every inch of that mountain. I haven't gone for the last few years, but In the valley there, they have a bench with a scripture verse, and it says, I look up to the mountains, from where shall come my help? And I was blessed when I was in eighth grade. I wasn't sure if I was going to go to East Lyme High School or St. Bernard High School, and so I went hiking with a group of people. We went up to Mount Washington, and I came back and decided to go to St. Bernard High School. But that was one of those, you know, turning points in my life. I was able to run on a cross-country team that won the state championship, and that had a, you know, all of it had a big impact on my life and a big trajectory. And it all started with that trip up the mountain. Mountaintop experiences, we need them. We need them. Because Jesus knew that Peter, James, and John were going to need that experience on top of Mount Tabor. Because he knew they were going to experience what he was going to experience. They were going to witness his crucifixion, his passion and death. And so it was a way to show his glory. The word transfiguration in Greek means metamorphosis, and the church fathers have all spoken about this tremendous metamorphosis, this tremendous change that is supposed to happen in all of us. But did you ever consider that the Sunday Mass could be a mountaintop experience? Granted, you may not feel that way every week, but faith tells us that this is where heaven meets earth. I can't help but think of Scott Hahn in his book, The Lamb of God, where he talks about realizing that the Mass was the book of Revelation, and all the angels and saints and the holy, 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 and everything that's in the book of Revelation was right here at the Mass. We don't see it, but it's something that we can experience in faith. And you've heard me say over and over again, the thing that gives me greatest comfort is to know that all our dearly departed loved ones, the whole heavenly hosts of saints and angels, are with us at each and every single Mass. I'll never forget, I went on a priest retreat with Father Ray. It was in Malvern, Pennsylvania. It was at the retreat house of St. Joseph in the Hills, and it was a charismatic priest retreat, and you've heard me tell the story. I remember Monsignor said, "We're going to pray that the walls will shake." I'm like, yeah, okay, show me. A skeptical young priest. Well, my walls shook. Someone came over and prayed over me, and I said, uh-oh. And I felt that I was going to fall backwards and be slain in the spirit. And I had a choice. This is how good God is. I could have dug in my heels and said, no, this is not going to happen. This is not going to happen. But I yielded, and I felt on fire. I felt the most incredible sense of peace. And I'll never forget celebrating Mass. We celebrated Mass with all the priests that were there. Father George Kosicki from the Stockbridge Shrine of Divine Mercy, Father Ray, Father Bob DeGrandis, all these big names in the Catholic Church, they were all right there celebrating and experiencing this one thing that we're talking about today, the transfiguration of the Lord. But we need those mountaintop experiences. We need them to live in, because we can't stay on top of the mountain, and God won't let us stay on top of the mountain. We need to come back down. But on the mountaintop, you see forever. You get a perspective of things. A few years ago, I went out to Lake Tahoe. I always wanted to go up Heavenly Valley. My mother had always told us about how that's where she learned how to ski. She went with a stewardess friend, and she didn't know how to ski. And the stewardess friend told her, "Don't worry, you can take the ski lift down." Surprise! They got to the top, and they had to slip and slide their whole way down the mountain. But it's spectacular. So I went in the summer months, and you can see from the top. You can walk up to the top, and you can see Lake Tahoe. You can see all the different layers of blue and green. It was a crystal clear day. I was just by myself. I said, so this is a little taste of heaven. And that's what these mountaintop experiences are. Our hope here at Christ the King is that you'll have a mountaintop experience. You'll have something that'll keep you going throughout the week. We're so blessed to have a wonderful music program. You know, I've woken up in the middle of the night with a recessional hymn or a song that we sang during the Mass. That's how the experience of celebrating the liturgy can extend all throughout the week. And the last thing is we hear Jesus say, "This is my beloved Son with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." We learn to live as beloved sons and daughters of the Father. God the Father never ever stops looking at us looking at you, looking at me, saying, you are my beloved son, you are my beloved daughter, I love you. We need, it's a contemplative gaze. We need that. We need to realize that we're cherished by God, that we are God's beloved. There are so many things in this world that'll knock us down, whether it's finances, sin, you know, difficulties in relationships, the normal pinpricks of daily life. That's why we come to Mass, not because you have to, but we come to experience the Sabbath, that contemplative gaze where God the Father never stops looking at you and looking at me. Lastly, you know, this is the time of year where they have the youth conferences, and I'll never forget going to youth conferences. I came in touch with a song that brought back memories from being at Steubenville conferences early on. And have you ever heard that song, Shine, Jesus, Shine? Imagine being surrounded by thousands and thousands of young people singing, Shine, Jesus, shine, fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze, set our hearts on fire. Blow, Spirit, blow. And then it goes on and on and on. Imagine that. Imagine the singing, the clapping, the joy of being surrounded by thousands and thousands of young people. This is what's happening at World Youth Day as we speak. Young people from all over the world, they're descending on Fatima, they're descending on Lisbon. Pope Francis is there, Bishop Barron is there, bishops from all over the world are there. The church is alive. The church is young. The church is ever new. And the church wants you and me to have a mountain experience, a mountaintop experience, every time we come to Mass. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We are gathered to celebrate the mystery of our salvation in Jesus Christ. Let us ask God our Father to open for all the world this fountain of life and blessing.
That our Holy Father and all bishops, priests, deacons, and religious will be enriched by the gifts of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that it will joyfully proclaim the living word of God to all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That pastors may lead in faith and serve in love the flock entrusted to their care by Christ the Good Shepherd. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we recognize that we are beloved sons and daughters of God, and to listen for his voice every day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and oppressed, for the sick and those who care for them, for those who feel isolated and lonely, and for all our friends and loved ones who need our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us in faith, reach their reward in heaven, we pray for Mrs. Patricia Ann DeMarco, mother of Reverend Anthony DeMarco, and especially for Bob Stabb and Kathy Mather, for whom this 5 p.m. Vigil Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Pray for all the young people at World Youth Day and for people around the world, that they may have an encounter with the living Lord Jesus that will touch their lives forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Father, hear the prayers of your people. Give us what you have inspired us to ask for in faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and of all his holy church. Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, and by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stains of sin, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of his chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how in the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Amen. mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, with the clergy, the religious, and your entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Thank you.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Those watching at home will make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. St. Michael prayer. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who crawl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Just a couple of announcements. Let's see, what do I go with first? Yeah, steak dinner. Next week, immediately after this Mass, we have the wonderful evening. It's the steak dinner sponsored by the Men's Club. Tickets are available in the Narthex. It's a wonderful way to build community and have a fantastic meal. You'll see signups for the Harvest Fun Day. There also are ballots for the Parish Pastoral Council elections. You'll see a little write-up on everybody there. I think that's it. Please take home a copy of the bulletin. Let us pray. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you will to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.